pleasant good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How do you do? This is your soul man to be with you until I get through. I want you to stand by and don't have no fear, because this soul man is here.
Although no one seems to know for sure, Early Wright just might be the first black disc jockey to work in the Mid-South, maybe even the entire South. By his account, he's been on the air about 48 years. According to WROX station logs, it's closer to 50. Either way you figure it, Early Wright has been spinning blues records in Clarksdale, Mississippi, since the Great Depression.
Okay, I used to be the manager of a gospel group called the Four Star Quartet. And I was the general manager of the group. I organized the group. And so we was broadcasting from Helena, Arkansas, KFFA. That's where we was broadcasting from. And so when this station came to Clarksdale, you know, I started working here in town, I went to the manager. Keeping going across that bridge, I went to the manager and bought me a 15-minute program. And that Sunday morning, fortune, he was listening, and I was making my personal appearance announcement on that 15-minute program, and had a pretty good route. And so that next week, he went trying to get in touch with me, and he kept on until he got in touch with me. And so he begged me for 2 weeks to be a DJ. I didn't know nothing about it. I didn't do anything about it. I wasn't worried about it. So he said, I asked him, what did I have to do? He said, you're going to have to play the blues. Well, we would like for you to play the blues. Play blues on it. I said, well, let me get back with you. I decided I wouldn't do it, and he worried me and got other people to worry me for 2 weeks. And I went to my pastor of my church. I said, listen, I said, man, worry me about a job. I had a job. I run the garage. I was a mechanic. A mechanic. I wasn't no jackleg. I was A. Fix it or don't charge it. That's the way it was with me. So I went to my pastor and talked with him. I said to him, I said, a man offered me a job and I got to play the blues. What are they going to do to me in church? He said, Eddie, let me think over that. He said, I'll tell you what you do. You go on and take the job and work 2 weeks. Promise the man, you work 2 weeks. And after that 2 weeks, I'll let you know whether it looked like it's something going to hurt you in your church. I said, okay. So I went on and worked that 2 weeks, and he came back to me and told me, said, keep on working. So I was playing gospel and blues. Coming from radio station WRX, Clarksdale, Mississippi. Your stepping laundromat is located up on Bolivar and Dr.
Early Wright is a bit of an oddity by today's radio standards. Although he's had plenty of offers in much larger markets, he's never strayed from Clarksdale. He has worked for only one station, AM 1450, WROX. According to Wright, it was never about money, it was about blues. And Clarksdale sits in the heart of the Mississippi Delta, the land that produced the greatest blues artists the world has ever known.
You know, years ago when I was a boy, we used to go out to a little town with two or three stores in it, you know. And on a Saturday when you go there, men like Lonnie Johnson, old blues men, you know, like those, you know, back in those days. Well, they'd get there, you know, with a guitar, you know, and play music, and I'd stay there. That's right. That's when I come to get acquainted with the blues. See, we used to live on a plantation. I was raised on a plantation, see? And we'd go to, these fellas can blow these harps, those harps, and play the blues on guitar. Well, they didn't have no amplifier, but they had guitars, you know, and we'd go out there and be like that in the little town. I'm crazy about blues music.
When Early Wright isn't working his 6 to 10 in the evening board shift, he's out hustling advertising for his show. Some advertisers have been with him for 30 years. They love his style, no lavish production, in fact, usually no copy. Just live ad lib over the microphone.
That was a beautiful number that I dropped on you at that time. I tell you what, I'm going to return back shortly. Right now, I'd like to tell you that Corner Grocery Store, that's located on Sunflower and 2nd Street in Clarksdale, is owned and operated by Ms. Sandry. But here's what, sell gas, oil, brake fluid, transmission fluid, and all kind of little snacks and knacks. Do you know all the teachers and all people that don't want a good heavy breakfast? They go there and buy their breakfast. They sell some of the best coffee in town. I'm not a coffee drinker. I drink for the sugar and cream. But everybody you talk with say the corner drugstore sell the best coffee that you can drink. So go by there and get your cup now. Will you do that for me? You will. What you know about that? Hitting hard on the Soul Man Show. Ladies and gentlemen, listen. The Thomas Liberty Supermarket on 3rd Street in Clarksdale, Mississippi. And this way that you have the greatest opportunity to save pennies, nickels, and dimes, because Thomas is open right now at the present time. This way that you'll be able to buy pork roast for only 79 cents. Can you beat it? No. Gallon size of sweet milk, you can drink as much as you want to now. You can buy it for $1.99 a gallon from Thomas Liberty Supermarket. He is closing and opening hours from 8 in the morning until 7 p.m. in the afternoon. Minimal things you got here is available for you right now. Those of you that missed buying something when you was in the store an hour ago, go to Thomas Liberty Supermarket. You can get Coke products. How many? Or you can get 12-ounce packets. You can get them $2.99 at Thomas Liberty Supermarket on 3rd in Clarksdale.
Early Wright is proud of the fact his radio show attracts black and white listeners. After 50 or so years on the air, just about everyone has heard of the Delta Blues disc jockey.
Well, I think they know of me if they don't know me. I think they know of me if they don't know me. And you hardly can find nobody. Don't have to stop in Clarksdale or most anywhere else to know. You might find some little teenage child. I went to the school Monday morning. I went over to the school. And later, some of the children said, you know who that is? One young man said, no, I don't. I said, that's Early Wright. He said, the Soul Man. No, not Early Wright, the Soul Man. Yeah, I know the Soul Man. But he didn't know me, no more than he heard me on the radio.
Is that a good feeling for you to have had such a big impact?
Well, it don't blow my head, but I appreciate it. It doesn't blow my head. In other words, I advise peoples daily, don't never let nothing affect them. Long as you don't be affected by a comment or how you're living or what have you, you can do all right. You got to consider you never own nothing in this world. Car do you buy cash? Don't buy a tag or sticker for it, you can't drive it. If you buy a house, and the governor wants that spot of land for a factory or something, you got to give it up. I don't care how well you like to live there. I mean, this may not be something you want to hear. Two things I ain't ashamed to tell. That I didn't get the amount of education I ought to should have had, and I'm the age that I am. I don't mind telling you. I'm 80 years old, February the 10th, past February the 10th. I was 80 years old.
Before he became a disc jockey, Early Wright worked as a painter, a mechanic, in a freight house, and on a train. He spent summers working for a dollar a day, hip high in water, digging levees. Great experiences, according to Wright, the main ingredients of blues, hardship and struggle.
I've had it hard. I've had it hard. See, I made a good man out of me, though. Good man. See, the Lord bless me. As long as you keep this here would count, what's on the inside of you. I'm gonna use it like this. Maybe if I've had a sugar tit in my mouth all my days, I wouldn't know anything about when a man say he hadn't had no breakfast. It'd be 3 o'clock in the evening. See, some children today, my children have lived a millionaire life. I came up so hard, I didn't want my child to live like I did. My children made it. For a poor man like me and scratching, making an honest, pure, clean, honest living, my children live good. I raised my two daughters good. I wasn't trying to spoil them, but I was just trying to do by them as I thought a man should do by his child, my family. And see, my child wouldn't know anything about it. If it had been plenty noontime, I hadn't had no breakfast. I had worked till noon. Wasn't nothing there to eat. I read on the stepfather, that means I didn't get no education. Because my stepfather wouldn't allow me to go to school when I should have went. when I could have gone, till we moved to Missouri. When we moved to Missouri and he tried the same thing, then they like to put him in jail. See, and then that's why, if I stayed in Missouri, I'd been a lawyer.
Have you ever thought about retiring?
Well, I've thought about it, yeah.
Do people love your voice?
I don't know.
Yes, they...
I'm afraid about it. And I know I got a southern voice, but I'm afraid about it. I don't try to change it. Don't nobody get my attention on trying to talk like them. I don't be nobody but Early Wright or the Soul Man. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How do you do? This is your soul man to be with you until I get through. I want you to stand by and don't have no fear, because this soul man is here.